Mr. Chairman and members of the committee, but for the fact that my son, my youngest son, Fernando, had a car accident, Timoteo, whom most of you know, he served in the 2003 legislature with some of you here. He would be here making this points. Some years back, early 1980 or so, the Texas Lyceum Conference was formed, and somehow or another, I was invited by Teaman Skipper Dipple. I don't know if all of you know him or some of you know him. A good man, a good Texan. But throughout the process, throughout the 30 years or so that I've known him, he's always included the Hispanic perspective on everything that we've done. About some years back, we selected him to receive the Conscience Builder Award, the Cesar Chavez Legacy and Educational Foundation, of whom I'm a board member, selected him to receive that award. And we when he came to our award, there was a march that was going to happen 2 days after the banquet. And he really wasn't all up to, you know, he's Federal Reserve Board and banker, being a march. But he found that march to be very different than what he expected. At the end, he saw nothing but red, white, and blue, issues that are important that possibly were not being addressed at that time. And through a series of books that he has published, the Language of Conscience, he has incorporated our perspective. And though we've been talking about it for 30 years, why is it important now? Because of the demographics. Right now, the issue here is junior colleges. Junior colleges better represent the demographics of our state. 44% of the students in junior colleges are Hispanic. 73%, I like 73 because that's my class. I'm a mechanical engineer, Texas A&M, 1973. Here you go. And I like my representative, Roberto Alonzo. I'm so proud of you. You see beyond. You have a vision, and you've been a strong voice for our community. Population rate now is 44% Hispanic. The population for Anglos, I think, is 43. It occurred 2014. So the junior colleges...
If we could just wrap up there.
Yes. The junior colleges provide a reflection on our K-12. That's the first time that you see whether we've done a good job or not. And we've seen them before, but that's a very good assessment. The second thing is that we want excellence in education. We don't want to reduce. We want to compete in a global economy. And so here, representing an organization, we have teamed up together, or we're teaming up with Texas Association of Community Colleges. They have reached out to us, such as the Texas Association of Business, Texas Public Policy Foundation. They've reached out to us now to get input. We don't want to, they're not giving us proposals where we say, do you approve it or don't you approve it? No, we want to be a part of making policy, helping them integrate it. So I know I've taken up more than my time, and I thank you so much for the opportunity.
Thank you. Appreciate your testimony. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Excuse me, Cedro Lopez was a famous Tejano singer and composer, and I apologize to Mr. Garza. My name is Marcos De Leon, former Travis County Commissioner here in Austin, Texas. I'm a product of two junior colleges, Student Texas College in Killeen, Texas, and Austin Community College here in Austin. I'm a class of 79 from University of Texas. There you go. And I went back to school in 2005, and now I have a master's in higher education from the University of Texas in 2008. For the last 15 years, I have spent on the trenches with high school students and middle school students here in Austin and Travis County area, and about five schools here in Austin. In the last 9 years, in Maynor Middle School and Maynor High School. My experience has been, and I share this with Representative, is the students. We're talking about the students. We're talking about young lives, how we shape those young lives, how they come and serve our country. One of the things I share with my students always as the college advisor is, someday you're going to be the leaders of our country. And they look at me like, what? But you have to understand that someone has to keep the democracy we have in this country. Someone has to keep the economics that we see it in this country. Someone has to keep the social fiber of this country. We need those folks to take those leadership, and you're the ones. Some of you may not, but the majority of you can do that. And let me share with you, the young Latino students, Chicano students that I'm involved with are hungry to go beyond high school. They what they need, they said, tell me is the path. What is the path, Mr. D? That's what they call me. They couldn't call me Mr. De Leon, so they call me Mr. D. So what is the path? And the path can be junior colleges. The path can be straight to four university. But the paths are there, but how do we teach you that? And how do we prepare them to do that? We understand, and I share with Dr. Paredes, the image of community college sometimes is very negative. Oh, I don't want to go there because I want to go to UT, or I want to go to A&M, et cetera, et cetera. But all my students, I force them to apply at ACC. When they go to Texas State and they can't handle the physics class at Texas State, come back to Austin, go to ACC, and take it there, and then go right back. So I want to share with Dr. Paredes, some of these students who don't actually graduate from community college or actually are taking the next course, or they do it within the year, and they go and apply at a university and get accepted. So there's a lot of different dynamics when you're dealing with graduation rates and all that. I'm disappointed because I'm a product of ACC. I'm very proud. I tell my students, oh, I went to ACC. I'm a bat. So you can be that too. But I think it's the image is part of it, the image of junior colleges. What is it? To many of my students, it's a stepping stone for you. Learn your basics there. You know, less expensive for your family. And then once you're there, do what I did. What did you do? I had a 3.7 when I got out of ICC. I went to UT, they said, come on in. So it's one thing I'm going to junior college, another thing I'm setting those standards high for yourself. And I do, I'm a no C man. C to me, see you later. You're not gonna go to college. But basically what I'm trying to share with you is what the ladies and gentlemen gave you, the presidents and associations, it is very important. And because our population is so high now, as young Latinos and coming to this into this state is so high, that we need to get ready. We need to be ready to help them achieve what they want to achieve. And we can't do it unless we all put our minds together and say, this is not about all this, this is about one thing, is our children in the state of Texas. What are we doing for them to make sure they have the opportunity to grow? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. De Leon. Members, questions for Mr. De Leon? Yes, Representative Alonzo.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just briefly, gentlemen, thank you for coming. And as you depart, I just want to make a comment about what you said, Mr. De Leon. It is important to hear from you, but also I heard something that comes to my mind about what the image the kids have of junior college. And it reminds me of this line from the movie, Let No Man Write My Epitaph, where Shelley Winters came out. And I say that because part of, as I've grown and gone through school, and I'm also a graduate of UT, is how we define ourselves. And I'm listening to that part about what we have to do is in order to counter that, because it is, you know, school. I went to UT undergrad. I went to TSU law school. I mean, it is what we make of it. So exactly. I'm listening. I'm hearing you. And I think one of the things that stands out from your comments is our kids need to know that junior college is big. It's important. And we have to create an image of it being that important, as you say, and as everybody that's here knows, we gotta back it up and talk it and make it so when they go, they feel not only are they getting the skills, but they feel fulfilled having gone. So again, I thank you for making that point. I appreciate it. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Representative. Anything else, members? Hey, non-panelists, thank you all very much. We appreciate you taking the time, and to all those who have come and testified before this committee,
thank you,
especially.